Hey guys, welcome back. Another tutorial on flashing fastboot ROM. And what happens if and so on. Okay, I will cover all. So this is a long video. I hope you understand. Bagi yang dari Malaysia ataupun dari Indonesia, saya harap kamu paham dan pati betul-betul. Yang ini, this is 9S, Note 8 Pro, and Poco F1. At your PC, there is a USB port 2.0, or older one PC 1.0, and the new PC USB 3.0, that's the problem will arise. Okay, if you look at your device manager, and first of all your PC must be online, your laptop, whatever you use, otherwise the driver will not automatically install. And now I'm connecting it to my 9S. See here, this is the bootloader. Okay, I run the Mi Flash tool. I'm using the older version 2.312.2640 because of my older pawn. Untuk pawn lama, kamu guna besi lama. Untuk yang baru, boleh update yang terkini. Ni MI10, sebab MI10 sekarang connect ke kamera ni. Yang ini 9S. Refresh. Bermakna 9S boleh detect di Mi Flash Tool Pro ni. Kalau dia biru macam ni, if it is blue like this, that means it's okay on the Mi Flash Pro. How about Note 8 Pro? Also detect on my PC, Android bootloader. Can we flash it? No problem also. Note 8 Pro. How about Poco on USB 3.0? See? Poco problem. Lost. What is that? Okay, now Poco in fastboot. When I'm connect to my USB 3.0, see? Okay, let's go back to fastboot or Poco. What you need is USB hub. This is USB hub 2.0. connect to my USB 3.0 to 2.0. this is a hub. You need a hub for the pawn with this problem. This is my USB cable. Make sure you use the original Xiaomi USB cable or any cable that are good in connection. Okay. Now, no problem for Poco. See, detect. Okay. Back to the 9S. In case the driver are not installed, it's not detected here, what you need to do For 9S, you can use the USB 3.0 port, no problem. The driver install also no problem. And Note 8 Pro also no problem. For newer phone, no problem. Untuk phone yang lama saja masalah. Okay, in case the driver are not installed and not detected your phone, you need to run another installer, the ADB installer. The link for it I will give it below. You just tap enter yes, Y, type huruf Y, yes, and yes again, Y. Yeah, I can install driver. Yes, again, I can install driver secara automatic. My camera lost connection. Droid cam. Sorry, guys. Okay, carry on. Okay, now we're going to install TWRP and root the Redmi Note 9S. The ADB and the TWRP image in one folder. I already upload and you can download it. Hold shift button, right click on your mouse, open PowerShell window here. This is for Windows 10 only. Windows 7 more or less. And the command I already written it. Just copy and paste. Password, we're going to place the TWRP 9S. Copy and paste. And let me stop here. Why I didn't flash the BB meta first? On my previous video, pada video sebelum ni, saya flash menggunakan ni, dia auto sekali flashing the BB meta first and then fast boot. This is the auto installer, but now I'm not flashing this BB meta. Is it mandatory? No, flash saja TWRP. Okay, it's okay. Okay, let's see the all the partition inside the 9S. Pass, boot, get, bar. What's the problem with the 9S? Because of the Android 10. The security on older Android 10, there is system, your vendor, your user data, your cache, your boot image. But the newer Android 10 only got user data, boot, the vendor no more, the system no more, the cache is there. So where's these two gone? System and vendor. Actually it's in one partition combined. The partition are super. How big is this? This is a binary. We can convert the binary to megapixel. See, no more system and vendor. That's the problem with the newer Android 10. If you try to flash the JSI image, also you got the problem because the vendor inside here. That's why you need to flash vendor and the system image together. Okay, let's reboot to recovery. You can skip the video in case it too long for you. Kalau video ini panjang sangat, merepek, merapu, boleh skip. Masih holding volume plus and power button just now, still holding. First boot, holding again, tahan lagi untuk boot kedua. Second boot. Sometimes you have to change the language, change it to English. Now the recovery already installed. If you want to root it, go to Advanced. You don't have to disable the ABB 2.0, only on the Note 8 Pro. Install root and wipe. Okay, home. Another thing, if you go to the file manager, in my previous video, some of them also include me deleting the system. Nope. System root. System. Hey, is it that file? You see, you can see your system. Have to mount it first. And okay. I'll go to Advanced File Manager. System root. My previous video I did it recovery from boot inside the system. I delete this file, so now you don't have to delete in case you want to revert back to stock MIUI. Jangan delete file ni. Recovery from boot. Sekiranya nak balik ke stock MIUI. Okay. We already root the pawn dah di root. The reboot ke system. Lepas ni kita akan flash ROM India ataupun Ini adalah link untuk 9 Pro di XDA. Okay, the pawn already root. Link untuk fastboot ROM. Okay, saya akan download fastboot ROM 9S ni. Kita tengok about phone 9S. One is 9 Pro Indian version. Same also. The global version 9 Pro are different than 9S. The kernel are the same. The camera different. Also the NFC. If you want to download a fastboot ROM for the 9S over here, get. If you are using the global, get the global. If you are using the Indian, get the Indian. Okay, now I'm downloading the. Okay, Indian version. 1107. Okay. Yeah, the file Kutana 9S Kutana 9 Pro, the Indian version are Joyous. System update, no update. Yeah, boleh update terus sekiranya ada update. Cuma update tu ROM dia besar sikit, penuh. Jangan update yang setengah-setengah ROM tu. OTA. Bila dah update, manually reboot ke TWRP. Reboot dan tahan butang hold the volume plus while I'm downloading the image for Indian version, flashing it to the global version. Masuk ke TWRP for second time, only one time boot. First time it boot twice. Bila ada update, when there is an update, just go to wipe, advanced wipe, you wipe the Dalvik and wipe cache, these two only. Wipe and then install. Go to the, I think on the download folder, select your ROM and flash. Once again, wipe, advanced wipe, Dalvik and cache only. The data don't wipe when you update the MIUI. Bila dah update MIUI, cuma wipe Dalvik cache saja. Data tak payah sebab dia akan override. In case you want to use back the stock MIUI, sekira nak guna balik stock MIUI, pergi advance, unroot, buang root. Ni untuk 9S saja. Not 9 tak boleh. 9 Pro tak boleh guna. Cara dia sama. Ingat tu. Kalau 9 Pro Indian version boleh. Okay, download saya dah habis. Lepas ni kita akan repack dia punya file. Okay, normal root. If you try to boot back to the recovery, reboot, hold the volume plus, tahan volume plus. Okay, my download already finished. size file. See, now it's stock MIUI recovery reboot. This is the Indian global for Cortana. First of all, when you download it, 3.1 GB, extract it, extract the file with the 7-zip or any zip archive. S global MIX global, kita akan flash. Okay, sudah di extract. Inside this folder there is another archive, this time it's more bigger, 5.9 GB. Extract it also, archive in archive. Yeah, the global. Okay, I pull it to my desktop. The global Indian version. Now we are going to flash the Indian version to the global version. Okay, reboot to fastboot, connect your USB. Yep, it detect. Run your Mi Flash Pro as administrator. Nope, don't flash semi 10 row. Okay, this is the flash in fastboot, refresh. So my file are here on the desktop. Cari file tu, di mana kamu simpan, macam saya di desktop. Desktop, Cortana, this is the Indian version. IN, India. Kalau MI is global. ID Indonesia. Okay, select folder. Tukar script. Sekarang flash all lock. Ataupun kalau nak masih nak kekalkan data tu, flash all accept data storage. Kalau nak paling baik, paling bagus, the best are flash all. We don't want the problem arise. In case you got boot loop also, this is the only way to flash back the stock ROM. Okay, now we are flashing the Indian version to the global version. How long will it take? That depends on your PC. Maybe around 2 minutes. Second, already splashing super image, maybe 1 minute. Since I'm using the USB 3.0, more faster than the 2.0. You see the super image? How big the file? Yeah. 5 GB. If you look at the older porn, like the Redmi Note 8 Pro, there is a system and a vendor. System, vendor. for the newer 9S, that includes the MI10 also. Umi Super A-Bash. Yep, here. Normal vendor, all the system and the vendor inside here. Why Android? I don't know why. Security reason. How many minutes the video? 25 minutes. Oh, still okay. Minute. Pressing user data, the phone will reboot after this. BB Meta, custom image. See, finish, reboot. Can close the and plug off your USB cable. My global is now Indian version. Always use the original USB cable from Xiaomi or from your phone vendor, because the quality. If you got a good third party cable, then you can use it. Don't use the lousy one, otherwise your phone may break. And other website, this is the website for downloading the fast boot ROM. I will give the link below and also the custom ROM for the 9S, 9 Pro, Joyous, the Indian version, 9S global version, same ROM also, everything the same. I never try this one. This one is a GSI image. Only flash by a fastboot. Masih ROM also okay. This is based on MIUI 12, but still Android 11, I think. MIUI 11. The UI, the graphic interface, still are using the MIUI 12, but still based on MIUI 11. Okay, connect to my Wi-Fi, connect to 5G. And my password, wow, very long password. Sign in to your account. Bahasa Cina. Can I use Indian? Nope. My region, Malaysia. Pixel experience also okay, the ROM. Only Bluetooth problem. Line edge. Okay, after this we flash this line edge OS to this 9S. Let me download it first. System to be meta. Don't have the vendor. This mean there is no Google Play inside. And you hold on. For the GF, Lineage OS. GF. Use OpenGF 110. Use Nano Pico Micro a bit big the file. Nano at least minimize, not so minimum like Pico. You can download the Nano. Okay. Line edge already. No, thank you. I don't use Xiaomi Cloud. Ah, very slow. The Google website. Yep. Line S copy to my Kingston. Okay, this is the Indian version of MIUI 11. What's the difference? This is the difference. The Indian version, the phone app, you can record. See, call recording. Compared to the global version, don't have the option for call recording. Untuk yang global, ROM dia memang tak ada call recording. Termasuk Indonesia punya ROM juga, kalau tak silap. cuma India, sebab India menggunakan MIUI phone app. Kebanyakan phone dia memang MIUI. Contact app pun MIUI, stock MIUI. Message pun okay, flashing custom ROM. Remember, we have to flash back the recovery. This is the Indian. Reboot. Hold the password. Volume down. Volume turun. Okay, pergi ke file kamu. Tekan S. Shift, right click on your mouse, open PowerShell. Malas nak type, ini saja cara dia. Dia lazy to type, just copy and paste. Done. I'm using a thumb drive. First boot. Still holding the volume plus. Reboot. Sure, my TWRP gone back to the stock MIUI recovery. See? Flashback recovery. Flash TRP minus. Okay. Now we can reboot. You can type over here, password reboot recovery dot image. First boot, it reboot again. Second boot, then you release the volume plus. Okay, connect my thumb drive. Wipe. This is installing custom ROM, Dalvik, data, cache. Three only, Dalvik, data, cache. And then home, wipe, format data. We don't want the MIUI user data. Clear it. Okay. Since the now I'm logged into my where is it? Line edge don't have the GF, you have to flash it. So one line edge, add more zip and your GF. Open GF. ARM64 Android 10 Nano. This is the latest one. Flash. Redmi Note 5 also masalah juga Note 5 dengan USB 3.0. Kena guna yang hub. Kalau komputer lama tak apa, tak ada masalah. Laptop lama ke? Memang tak ada masalah lah. Driver guarantee install. Ataupun bila dia tak install, guna app tu. ADB installer ni kamu run saja. Dia akan install. Pastikan port to connect ke PC. Link untuk tu saya akan sertakan sekali. Sekarang dia flashing GF. Rom dah selesai. Oh, GF problem. The system tak mounting. Error 70. Install GF. Open GF. Satu lagi kalau tak compatible memang dia error juga. Error code 70. Kena guna dia orang punya sendiri punya GF kalau tak silap kan ni. Kena main apa ada GF, just reboot. Need out GFs. No GF. See, no GF. Not bad. Camera inside camera inside camera. Okay, flash GF. Before we end the video, make sure you download the correct GFs. So, other custom ROM no problem with the OpenGF from here. Android 10 Nano ARM64 download. Why? Why I didn't hold the? It's put twice. Install USB OTG. Open GF 64 Nano. Come on, no error. mounting partition. I hope it's okay. Okay, now it's okay. Wow, very slow. 180 kilobyte. Nah. Bye bye. In my next video, I will use this ROM, Linux OS, for playing game. Stay tuned. Reboot. Disconnect. So always be careful whatever you do. Make sure the cable are connected firmly. Pastikan cable terkonek betul-betul. Kalau tak, terputus tengah jalan, rosak semua. Okay, line SOS. Nine Pro, eh? Not nine. Perol. That is it. Line S security masa April, security pass May. Oh, ni latest stable. Okay, that's it from me. Stay tuned for the next video. I hope you understand what you are doing, so be careful.